In this video, we're going to review the print checks function in AP. We'll go to the AP module, all checks, print checks. Now the print checks, the first thing you would set is your check style. If you're using a blank check, that means there's nothing printed on it and you run it through a special printer that has micro ink or magnetic ink. You know how you want to refer to it, you would choose this and you choose your bank. You have to set the bank up to use blank check stock. So if you don't have any bank set up, it's not going to show up here. If otherwise, if you use a pre-printed checks, you choose pre-printed as your style, and then you can select your bank. Now you need to understand something. This is a driver for this page. If you come here and you have the wrong thing selected, you're going to probably freak out because you're not going to find anything. But come here, where are all my checks? Where are all my checks? Where's my bank? This really should be up here at the top so that it points out that this is a main selection. But if you have issues, first thing you need to do is make sure you check the correct check style. I know you must say, well, I know it's set up as this, or I know it's set up as that. If you don't see your bank here and you don't see your checks here, go check your check style on your checking account. Trust me. Go check it. Don't assume. Well, see, in this case, once you select the bank, if you don't have any bills for that bank that were selected for payment, it's not going to show up either. That'd be the next thing you troubleshoot. So for this one, we have our Wells Fargo. We have two bills here ready for the checks to be printed on. We have our check number. You can adjust this if necessary. You can do it here, or you can do it in the bank setup. Preferably, you'd want to change the bank setup so you keep your numbers correct. Here, it just changes it on this particular, bills here, and it doesn't change it in the bank setup. So you can end up getting your numbers off, your check numbers off. You don't want to do that. So when you're ready to print, you would select print. And you can select confirm as well and try and print and confirm at the same time. It's not going to work for you. Intacct requires two-step confirmation on all checks that you print. So you can check that, but you're just wasting your time. Come here, the checks you want to select, click print. They'll print. It'll pop up with what you have. I'm just going to do one. I don't want to lose all mine right now. We'll do print. And it gives you a PDF of the check, what it's going to look like. Of course, it says void here because we're in the sales demo. So yours would not say that, would not have that watermark. You have your check part, you have vendor stub, you have your stub, the check stub. You can change the information that's on here based on check stub details, vendor stub details. Now you see these little blue dots? This gives you a little pop-up help that you see right there. It's really neat. I like those. And don't forget, if you have see a little question mark, that's a help. And help and support, help on this page will help you a lot of times. So you can select this information to see what details come on here. Now, since we have not confirmed it, see, once you print the check, it automatically checks the confirm void button. We can reprint it. It'll tell you, oh, you've already printed this. They had unsigned numbers. To avoid printing the check more than once, either select and confirm the previously printed check or deselect them, blah, blah, blah. I don't care in this particular case. So here is that one. Now you see, this is the additional information that's selected for both tabs. Now, if we look over here, it looks very similar. Except that if you notice the difference down here, see, there's a difference there. Now you're probably saying, well, where's the check number? Well, the check number is on your pre-printed check because it's a pre-printed check, but it advances that away. Now we can confirm it. Until we confirm it, it doesn't show up anywhere. You will not see it. Well, it'll show up in view payment request, but not as a posted payment. It will not show up in posted payments. And I believe we went over that in AP Advances. but you won't see it in posted payments. You won't see it in the AR ledger. Until it's confirmed, it's sitting out in nowhere land. And if you try to create another check, it's normally going to give you a big old error saying, hey, you need to look at this, man. You have a check out there that's not confirmed. So you come here and confirm. Now, suppose you try to confirm without printing. Let's confirm. You get an error. You can't do this, jerk. Go back and do it the correct way. So it'll do that. So you cannot confirm a void without printing first in this screen as it's set up. So we come here, we'll click confirm, do confirm. You see it disappears from our print check screen. If we go to posted payments, we'll see it here. I forgot what the check was. So you know what? I don't even remember which one we just did. At any rate, it's there now. I think it was this one, A1 Electric. Yeah, it was. Now it's there, and it'll be in the AP ledger. Trust me, I didn't look at it, but it's there. And that's how you do your print checks. Now, if for some reason, when you printed the check, it got all mangled or something, you could void it here, and it'll just go back to the bills as posted, and you come back through here and select it to pay again without having to reverse anything. Because it's not been confirmed, it doesn't actually exist until you confirm. And that is going to be our print checks overview.